In the United States, the typical prison cell is about 6 to 8 feet, encased in steel walls and barred with a door that locks from the exterior. But there's another prison cell that holds more men captive than all the industrialized prisons in the world. What's extraordinary about this prison cell is that it locks from the inside and can only be inhabited by an inmate who voluntarily turns himself in. No warrant, just a good man who is tired of fighting to feel. Emotional incarceration is a self-imposed mental prison that confines a man's non-masculine emotions and isolates his heart from the world. Due to the lack of safe spaces for us to express our emotions, we choose to stay incarcerated to avoid being humiliated for just trying to be a human. Even Drake says in one of his songs, "I pop bottles because I bottle my emotions." But holding it in is dangerous because when life shakes us, we eventually pop like bottles. It is no surprise that data shows in just about every country, men die by suicide 3 times as often as women. And when I ask men why they believe this is the case, they all agree the main reason is because we fear being vulnerable and will not express our emotions. And since crying is universally considered a violation of manhood, the only tears you will publicly see on a man's face are tattooed. As a result, those of us who've experienced trauma and are under significant stress struggle to release it. Biochemist Dr. William H. Frey discovered that emotionally induced tears contain not only water, but stress hormones that are released from the body through crying. So when you tell a boy, "Big boys don't cry," or "Man, stop acting like a bee," you cut off their humanity and sentence them to a life of emotional misery and mental anguish. I continued suppressing my emotions until I almost lost the marriage and family the Most High blessed me with. I pursued psychotherapy and camaraderie that welcomed vulnerability, and learned how to release years of trauma and emotional pain that I had been conditioned to suppress in my heart and mind. I was finally free to feel. From childhood, we add bars to our mental cells when we experience failure, embarrassment, and/or rejection. And when a boy becomes a man, those same bars eventually become walls. The school bully is now an intimidating coworker who stops you from going after a position, an open position with higher pay than his. And fatherlessness or mother wound has you seeking affirmation via pornography, and now you're addicted. Do you see how all of this plays out? If so, sit up and get off the bed in your mental jail cell. Take a slow step toward the open door to the life you longed for. If you're hesitant, that's okay, but keep moving, brother. You've been through a lot. The fact that you're listening to me now confirms that you haven't given up and are willing to take the journey inward. Take a moment to write these questions down and answer them later. What emotions keep you emotionally imprisoned daily? This could be unresolved anger, self-pity, or fear of failure. What are the events in your life that led you to emotionally incarcerate yourself? And lastly, what areas in your life do you need to achieve victory, and what do you need to do in order to start waging and winning the inner war to attain it? If you feel up to it, share these questions and your answers with someone you trust. This will help you begin the process of escaping emotional incarceration. You're doing well, warrior. So keep fighting the right fight. Shalom until next week, and do not forget to buy your copy of Battle Cry.